Albert S. Hall School Laker Robotics Team, also known as the 10 Musketeers. We have been learning about abused and neglected animals. We have done interviews, read books and magazines, completed internet searches, and learned from people in our community from various presentations. We are happy to present to you now our How to Help Animals in Our and Your Community presentation. Enjoy.
Why do people hurt animals? People harm animals when they put a human need for animal needs. Sometimes there are simply too many cats and dogs, and not enough homes to take care of them. Also, people run out of money and cannot take care of their animals.
What is animal abuse? Animal abuse is killing or attempting to kill any animal without legal permission, injuring or overworking, torturing or tormenting an animal, abandoning an animal, giving an animal poison, drugs, or alcohol to harm them, not giving an animal medical attention, not providing shelter, weather protection, or clean place to live, leaves an animal on a deserted island off the coast of Maine from December to March, hunting, selling, or trapping animals illegally, leaving an animal in a vehicle during extreme heat or extreme cold.
What do you do when you find a neglected or abused animal? Dr. Daniel from New England Animal Hospital says,
don't touch!
Never try to pick up the animal or stop abuse by yourself. Get help from someone you trust, parents, teachers, relatives, and friends.
Call for help!
Get a local animal rescue group. Next, we will show you some of our local resources.
Who can help? New England Mimic Animal Hospital in Waterville, Maine, 207-873-4668. American Society for Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, otherwise known as ASPCA. You can contact them at www.aspca.org. Waterville Area Humane Society, 207-873-2430. Waterville Animal Control, 207-680-4700. Charlie Strays in Clinton, Maine, 207-426-9482. Save Our Strays in Winslow, Maine, 1-888-772-3162, or Maine Department of Agriculture and Conservation, 1-877-269-9200.
Are there any success stories from rescued animals?
Yes, let's take a look at some. Look at this happy dog, its new owner.
Are there any others?
Yes, this poor pup was so abused by his owner that he lost his eye. But now he has a new family and a happy life.
Have you ever heard of PETA?
Oh yes, the People of Ethical Treatment of Animals. They rescue thousands of animals every year.
Very cool.
Here's a happy cat with a new friend. I think we can be very happy together.
I know about a dog from Maine. Her name is Nikita. She was found to be 15 to 20 pounds underweight. Now she has gained 30 pounds and she's living the life of luxury with a retired couple that adore her in Maine.
Really?
Oh yes, helping animals is the right thing to do.
Do they only help dogs and cats?
No. Here's a story about a horse named Sadie. Sadie is a 20-year-old Apollo that is blind. She needs her friend Storm to help her around the paddock. They both were found to be neglected and now live happily ever after together.
Oh, I'm so glad people all over the world help an animal.
Me too.
We hope this video has helped you learn more about helping animals safely. Help an animal in your neighborhood today. Help us help them.
We hope our presentation has helped you learn more about helping animals in your community. Thank you for helping us help them.
Thank you so much. I have two questions to ask. First is that why are you interested in this topic? And then my second question is that where did you get all the information? There's a lot of information there.
We interviewed people from our community and we researched online to get all the pictures.
Well, since there's a lot of abuse and neglected animals, we thought it would be a good idea to teach people about how to, like,
be safe
around. Be safe around. There's neglected animals.
We went to our local doctor, animal doctor down the street from our school, Dr. Danner. He told us, he wrote any questions that we thought of and when we asked him. So he didn't give us all, we didn't get some of the answers. We got some answers that we needed to know, but then we also researched the rest of the questions that we needed to learn more about.
We also read from books and we used the internet to help us.
We learned a lot about AIDS personally. We read a lot of articles from that.
How did you decide how to do your presentation with the video?
Technology. We all have our research tabs, and a lot of us like the internet, using the internet. So we found, and somebody came in to talk about how they use for their students how they use iPads. So then we got interested in it. We picked that up and we found an app called Shadow Puppet that we use to, and actually our coaches did not figure out how to use it. It's actually me.
We all got part in deciding what pictures.
Scripts, people got pictures.
We all wrote our script.
Yes, we all wrote scripts.
Who have you shared your presentation with?
Our school.
We used the projector. Yeah, we had an assembly and we shared the presentation with the whole school.
Did they give you any feedback about your presentation?
A little from our principal, but not a lot from the classrooms. Mm-hmm. Except, I don't know if you guys are back.
A lot of them complimented us.
Yeah. My classroom when I went back was really amazed by it.
Yeah.
And complimented us.
Yeah.
And the next day we found a board that says good luck.
The next day when we went to our lunchroom, in the cafeteria, there was a big sign, and it said good luck Lego Robotics team with all our names on it.
It was a nice surprise from some of our people who worked in the office.
Very nice.
Good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a good day.
Good luck on the rest of your day.
Thank you.